Hey there, this is Karen from Ozone Fine Art Ventures. Let's check out some fossils.
From where?
Here. It's pretty heavy. With history. Can't wait to see what's in here. From there. Pennsylvania rock hunter sent me this generous parcel of goodies. The most exciting of which are fossils from the Waynesburg Formation, way back in the Carboniferous and Permian periods. Great fern leaf fossils like this are abundant, that are like the ferns that we have today. And then there are fossils from extinct plants. Imagine a swampy coal forest that had tree ferns that grew up to 100 feet in height. This is believed to be the bark or mesozylon from one such tree, possibly the Chordates. They had long, narrow leaves, growing up to 27 inches in length. They had parallel leaf veins also, which helps us with the identification. I have a feeling we're going to see more of these guys as we unwrap this box. There were several calcite samples, and oh, there's that leaf I was just talking about. Its impression left in this shale. As we enlarge it, you can see the parallel striations that are the remnants of its veins. Seen here on the modern palm leaf, like that of the fossil leaf. And right next door is a really good looking fern leaf. Right about now, you might be asking, how old is all of this stuff? Really old. Back when the continents were part of the supercontinent, Pangaea, this region of future Pennsylvania and its surroundings were a basin filling with mud, silt, sand, and limestone deposits, setting the perfect stage for swampy plant life to be preserved for upwards of roughly 251 to 323 million years. That's a lot of years to fit into that box I got. It left me wondering what other fossils might be in here. I was looking at the fossil plates, and one of them had an incredible impression that bore a striking resemblance to a feather. And I was wondering, is it possible that we had one of their ancestors on the fossil plate? Wouldn't that be cool? So I measured it and started researching the animals from that era. And it turns out that birds don't hit the scene for another 100 to 150 million years. We also barely missed the dinosaurs at the end of this era. Sorry, dinosaurs. There were plenty of marine-going creatures, like the ancestors of the nautilus, trilobites, amphibians and such. It was an insect's world, and there were giant dragonflies with great wingspans. Okay, what's up with crossing out these creatures? Oh yeah, we have such a great fossil record there because the end of the Permian period marked the biggest mass die-off that we know of. What an unusual eyeful that must have been. And I bet you're wondering what it looks like now. Meet the birthplace for these fossils. From discovery in the beds to Pennsylvania rock hound's workbench. It's cool to be holding this in my hand, something that came all the way from there and tells us such an interesting story about where our continent got much of its coal fuel sources. Look at the amazing detail captured in the fossil impression. Also, notice it broke between here and there, a definite acknowledgement of its delicate and transient nature. Survived hundreds of millions of years, falling apart in my hand. It turns out there were a plethora of different kinds of ferns back then. They made up a large portion of the Carboniferous coal forests. And as for my pseudo-feather fossil, it's most likely a very large fern leaf imprint, like that of Macroneuropteris, also known as medullosa, and they might have grown 25 to 30 feet tall. The tree ferns such as medullosa and picopteris and other seed ferns of the past are similar to each other, so we could have many different species throughout these fossil plates. And here's a little guy we haven't covered yet. Instead of a leaf, this could be a stem or stalk of the Calamedes. They had sections or segments, as well as ribbing, or what looks like corrugation. They were not unlike our modern horsetail plant, like you may have in your yard. But like many other things from this period, these were giants that may have grown up to 50 feet in height. These plants a tender memory of their gigantic ancestors, leaving vestiges for us to find and discover what they were and what life was like in their ancient era. As for the other rocks and beautiful gems included in the box, they're going to show up in a future polishing video. Thanks again, Pennsylvania Rock Hunter, for your very generous and appreciated parcel. It was an invitation to all of us to explore the wonderful plant fossils of the Waynesburg Formation. If you're interested in more information, I've included resources in the description, and let me know if you have any corrections or additions in the comments.
Thank you for watching. The ducks and I appreciate it. Subscribe, and we'll see you next time.
For more, check out ozonefineart.com and keep creating.